What's going on, guys? Utana 12 here, and welcome to yet a... another unboxing. This time we have a pretty big box sent all the way from Australia. I do know who sent this, and for privacy reasons we shall be unnamed. But, I mean, we already took the pricing info off of this anyway, so there's nothing on it. But yeah, so let's get right. I've already started. Let's get started. Except I'm already halfway into doing it. Aww. Myself in the nose. This is actually quite tough. Any tools with me, so I had to quickly go and grab a screwdriver just to try and help pierce this thing. A lot easier. Alright. I guess we should be doing it this way. Also try not to break the screwdriver in the process. I need to look at the bag. Just ripping off the Australia Post logo now. All right, please. Swap off to the side. Okay. Screwdriver in the end. Yay! We got it open, and the first thing I see is a whole load of bubble wrap. Okay. Goodness. Okay, so let's pop that down there, off to the side, and we do have, you can probably tell what they are already. Yes, there you go, that's exactly what it is. Okay, so which one's this one? So we've got a phone case for the iPhone 11 Pro Max, which we also have iPhone 11 Pro Max. So this one, I'm just going to pop off to the side. This one in here, more or less the same thing. Yeah. So yet another iPhone 11 Pro Max case and another iPhone 11 Pro Max. I believe that one, actually this one here isn't mine, so these both go off to the side, and this one comes back. Okay, so just want to do some certain size comparisons quickly. This is my existing iPhone 8 Plus, which I did do an unboxing way back when on this channel. Since then, it has survived fairly well. Oh, you can see my reflection. With a cracked back glass. And the front, more or less, is doing quite well. There are no cracks at all. There's a couple of air bubbles because I put a screen protector on it. And I do have this existing Paper Mario case for an iPhone 8 Plus. So it's going to feel... gonna feel bad, pretty bad to retire that. Anyways, let's put the phone off to the side again. Start off with the phone case, because I'm actually curious, will it fit the iPhone 8 Plus?
Right, so this one is fairly easy. This is a fairly flexible case
by a company called Gooseberry. So let's take the Paper Mario case off, see if the iPhone 11 Pro Max case fits the iPhone 8 Plus, which, yeah, it does. It looks a bit weird, but that's surprising. The power button is mismatched completely. The volume buttons are slightly mismatched, but hey, it fits. There's that. Okay, let's pop them off to the side. And now we move on to the iPhone 11 Pro Max unboxing. So no knives here, just a pull tab, which is very unlike how it was previously, I believe. I'm not entirely sure. I haven't seen that video in ages. But again, pull tab. The cellophane folds away. Then you can do that. Box, once again, consistent with the iPhone 6s Plus and the iPhone 8 Plus, actually is a bit bumpy around the camera lenses and around the edges of the phone, which is to be expected. It makes it feel like your phone's actually there. But anyways, big reveal. Okay, so let's pop that one off to the side. And first thing we are presented with is the phone, the iPhone 11 Pro Max. Now, okay, and I'm getting fingerprints all over this already, so I'm going to immediately put the case on. Okay, and this is what it looks like. Again, let's pop the phone off to the side and see what else is in the box. So we have designed by Apple documentation, a new hello thing, some more stickers, because you can never get enough of those, SIM card tool, this is the basic documentation, basically. We also have what looks to be an Australian wall adapter. I believe this is the 18 watt one that charges extremely fast. It will be, and this is going to be very useful, because the current charger I have is one suited for an iPad that is 12 watts, and it is British, so at least I can still use it, but I'm going to need an adapter with this one. Anyways, now stuck to my hand. Just go down there. also have another pair of in-ear headphones. I believe these are the lightning enabled ones. No lightning to headphone jack adapter, unfortunately. But yeah, there you go, lightning connect. Then that lightning connector ones. So let's just. Oh my lord. Out you come. Please. Perfect. Awesome. Okay. And last but not least in here, the box is now completely empty, so now I can close it, put it off to the side. this is the charging cable, which I believe is USB-C. So that is awesome. That is amazing. So so that will do it for this unboxing. I'm going to go give this stuff over to who it's actually for now. So there you go. So thank you so much for watching this rather rushed video. So subscribe, comment, favorite, and like for more. And I will see you next time. There will be a couple more videos explaining this thing. Yeah, so thank you and bye-bye.
I just happened to notice I never actually turned it on, so here goes then. If it's not dead, there we go. Hopefully. There we go. Hello. Hello, I speak English. Yep, there we go. United Kingdom. Alright. Quick start, if you have an iPhone or iPad, I'm gonna do this via iTunes actually, so I'm just gonna quickly get all this. So, alright, I'll see you in a bit. Interesting little tidbit I noticed, but say you are out and about, you did bring a charger cable, but you don't have your 18 watt adapter to plug into a wall, but you do have a Nintendo Switch, and you are running low on battery on your iPhone. Now, typically, I don't know what would normally happen here, but because the Switch uses USB-C, and this cable also uses USB-C, plugging the charge cable USB-C end into the Nintendo Switch, if I can do this one-handed, and then you turn the switch on, the switch charges your phone. I don't know why on earth this is a thing, but it is. Okay, so I know I said I'll see you in a bit. That was recorded last year. Yesterday is the 1st of January 2020, and yeah, this was recorded, and well, here's the phone trying to look for my face right now with the infrared camera. There we go. Yeah, phone's all here, it's all set up. I'm trying to make sure that the notch stays hidden. Why is that thing blinking infrared?
I don't know what it's doing, but apparently it's looking for something, some infrared signal. Alright then, okay. Right. So then, and yeah, look, three cameras. And you can see
a bunch of reflections of it. Okay, alright, enough messing around. Okay, so thank you all for watching. Subscribe, comment, favorite, and like for more. And I will see you next time.
Bye-bye.